Welcome to the Speedcast Compass Customer Portal, your gateway to complete visibility and transparency for your network services. At Speedcast, we understand the importance of personalized customer support. That's why we've made it easy for you to access our dedicated 24/7 customer support team directly through the Compass Portal. Join us as we walk through the portal, showcasing the helpful features and functionalities that customers have access to. This is the login screen. If you have your credentials, you can enter them here. If not, you can click Register Now. This will take you to a form that, once submitted, will be sent to the Compass team. Once you have received the credentials, you can come back to the login screen and enter them. Once you have logged in, if you have multiple companies associated with your account, you will see the Select Company screen. From here, you can choose a company, and that will show all of the relevant services associated with that account. This will load the map view. The map view can be either in this 3D Earth, or it's toggleable to 2D up here in the upper right-hand corner. On the map, you'll see all of your sites or vessels that have GPS associated with them. And we can click either on the map or on the sidebar in order to view the relevant statistics to that modem. Up at the top, you'll see we have a map view. This shows the GPS locations according to the modem for the device over the historical time period, which is 24 hours. Right below that, we have a uptime bar. For here, all of the green is the uptime, and you'll see we had a slight little outage here in the red. Below that, you'll see all of the statistical graphs. These statistical graphs are all synced together, both with each other and with the map up above, and you can see at the top that the big dot is following the GPS location. We also have a time selector up here in the upper right-hand corner, and you can choose different times so you can see historical data for your modems. The default is 24 hours. If you select a different time, you can also download these in CSV or in Excel format, and this allows you to create your own reports. For this modem, we have signal strength, bandwidth utilization, and return errors. Each modem has slightly different statistics based on the technologies and what we can get out of them. These graphs are zoomable, so you can click and drag in order to zoom in on a certain time period. Double clicking will zoom back out. These are also zoomable horizontally, so you can get a better view of peaks and valleys. And as Starlink's authorized integrator, Speedcast customers will have access to Starlink's network statistics via the Compass portal. It will provide an approximate location of the kit, and then below that we have our data statistics for the month. You'll see your data usage. This is cumulative for the month, as well as the most recent signal quality. Below that, you'll see any active alerts that are available. These alerts will update every 15 seconds, and they will show anything that was active in the last 15 seconds as well. These show anything that could affect the service, for instance, any obstructions to the antenna or any pending reboots. Below that, you'll see your service line usage. The service line usage is the total amount of usage that you have for this month, broken down over a 24-hour period. Below that, you'll see your signal quality, throughput, latency and ping drop rate, obstruction, and your modem uptime. In addition to modem statistics, we have several other types of statistics that are available to provide you with the transparency and visibility for your services, including the availability for new tech modems. This will provide you with last month's availability, as well as this current month's availability. It'll provide you insights into why there were any outages and what was done to adjust them here in the outages table. For vessels that have antenna control units on board, we're able to show statistics from those antenna control units. We can see here we have a compass that has the heading of the ship also visible as a numerical value over here. This also shows the direction of the antenna in this green line, and then any blockage zones in the grayed out areas. This also shows the elevation of the antenna. We can see that the blockage status is clear, and then we have a map for the location of the vessel over here on the right-hand side. When you scroll over the graphs, you'll see that the statistics change. Move the heading of the vessel as well as the direction of the antenna and where they are on the map. And if the antenna were to fall into a blockage zone, it will highlight that the antenna is blocked. We also have tracking on IP interfaces. This will bring up traffic statistics on throughput, availability, and a table that breaks down availability in easy to digest increments. We also have the ability to show Cisco IP SLA data. From here, we can see our latency graphs, jitter, packet loss, availability, and our MOS score, as well as an availability table. Finally, we also have router statistics. Routers show the response time, percent loss, availability, CPU, memory, and additionally the availability table. Along the top, we also have different sections of the site. So we have a performance tab. From here, you can see your uptime across all of your different modems. This will be broken down on the modem type, so NewTek, iDirect, or Starlink. And you can hover over these in order to see what the time was that they were online or offline. And you can click on these to go to the specific modem statistics as well. These are searchable up here at the top, and they are paginated. There are reports available as well. We have our services overview report that shows all of the services for your account. This provides more of an overview of each of the modems, and so that you can compare them directly to each other. Also under the reports tab, if you have IPSLAs available, you'll see an IPSLA overview. This provides high level view of all of your services as the service overview report, but for your IPSLA data. If you have Starlink accounts, you will be able to see all of those grouped together in an overview report with the Starlink overview section here. We also have the support section. From here, you can view all of the cases associated with your account. These are searchable with the search bar up here, but they also have filters in the upper right-hand corner. Here, you can filter by service, status, or priority. These are exportable to CSV. And you can also open a new case by clicking on the new case button here. So I'll automatically fill in your company and your email address. We also have change requests. Change requests are required to still be submitted by your SDM, but you're able to view them all on the change requests part of the support menu. Finally, we have the Manage My Services tab. From here, if you have any Starlink kits that have been ordered from Shop Speedcast, you can activate your kits via this section here by clicking Agree to Starlink Management. And then if you have any Starlink kits that are available, these will show up and allow you to name them and activate them by choosing a plan. If you have active kits, you can view them from your Manage My Services overview of services. This will take you in to view all of your current plans. It'll tell you the site or vessel name that you have chosen, the kit name, the status, and the current plan that it is on, as well as the activated date and whether or not you are opted in to priority data. Finally, up in the upper right-hand corner, we have our toggle for our light mode and our dark mode. We have a new case button. You can use this to quickly create a case, either regarding your service or regarding any bugs that you might find in Compass. We have an alerts icon, which will show if there are any alerts that are currently active for any of the modems on your account. And then we have the user icon. This will allow you to manage your account, including any information about yourself, as well as your photo, and then some default settings for Compass itself, including whether or not the theme is light or dark, the language setting, and the start page. If you select a different start page, every time you log in to Compass, it will go directly to that page instead of the map view. You can also change your password here. We also have any resources that are available here in the upper right-hand corner. Before we conclude, we want to emphasize the importance of account security. To protect your sensitive information, please be sure to log out after each visit to the portal. If you're a Speedcast customer and would like access to the portal, simply visit the portal homepage to register for an account or create a support ticket. We're here to assist you every step of the way. If you have any questions or need further assistance, please explore the resources section within the portal or reach out to our dedicated Speedcast customer support team. Thanks for joining us for this Compass Portal demo.